Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
There was a big competition today for headlines and also for TV time or camera time. And you can figure out what I'm talking about. There was Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Western UP, in Mathura, Greater Noida, etc., giving speeches, inaugurating a few things, also serving the 300 crore or 3 billionth meal for Akshay Patra, which is a wonderful voluntary initiative to provide midday meal to school children. But at the same time, Priyanka Gandhi landed in Lucknow along with Rahul, of course, and they carried out a big road show from the airport to the city. Now, for the first time in a long time, it looked like there was competition for Mr. Modi on, as I said, headlines and camera time. And it was, attention was about evenly divided on most channels, but it did look like there was greater interest today in Priyanka than with Mr. Modi. But that is easy to understand because Mr. Modi is seen every day. He speaks everywhere. He was yesterday speaking in Andhra Pradesh, for example. He addresses two to four meetings every day. So there is something routine about that. But Priyanka, there was a novelty value. And there was quite a bit of excitement in Lucknow. And a lot of the media was also there. Now, this is hype. It may survive another few days. It may survive a week, 10 days. But what does it mean? What does it mean for the Congress? And what does it mean for the larger politics nationally and also in Uttar Pradesh? Because remember, she has been given charge of Eastern Uttar Pradesh while she is one of the 13 general secretaries of the Congress party. But her charge is Eastern Uttar Pradesh, and Western Uttar Pradesh has been given to Jyotiraditya Sindhya, who is also a titan of the Congress party. Now, where does it take, where does Priyanka's arrival take Congress party's prospects? In Uttar Pradesh. Now, if you look at Congress party's situation in Uttar Pradesh, you can say, all right, the way can only be up because they were down to two seats in national parliament, Lok Sabha elections, just Rahul and Sonia, Amethi Rai Bareilly, the family pocket borough, and in the assembly, just about 10. In fact, they were so badly off in the last Lok Sabha elections that besides the two seats that they won, they were second only in 6, maybe 7 constituencies, and I can tell you which ones. There is one Ghaziabad, which is next door to Delhi, but they lost by 5 lakh votes there. So, big margin. There is Saharanpur, that's in Western UP. There is Kushinagar, way distant in Eastern UP, that's where RPN Singh, the former Congress minister, was contesting. There was Barabanki, sort of between Kushinagar and Lucknow. There is also Lucknow, but remember the person, the candidate who stood second in Lucknow for Congress party, Rita Bahuguna, daughter of former stalwart Hemvati Nandan Bahuguna, she then joined the BJP and is now a BJP minister in the state. So what this tells you is that Congress party was completely demolished in 2014 in the state, which sends 80 members to national parliament. Remember, in 2009, one of the reasons Congress did much better, improved on its numbers on 2004, was simply because it won 21 seats in UP, which then became 22, which was seen as a fluke, but which was also then seen as Rahul Gandhi's arrival on the scene. So, if Rahul Gandhi's arrival on the scene could take the party to an unlikely number of 22 in 2009, can Priyanka's arrival also do something like that? Now, this is easier said than done. Because elections are not just won now because somebody comes, and now in Priyanka's case, they are saying she looks like Mrs. Gandhi. That's okay. Mrs. Gandhi is the leading icon of the Congress party today. But remember, nearly 65% of the voters in UP in the coming elections would have been born after Mrs. Gandhi's passing away. So, do they have any nostalgia about Mrs. Gandhi? But at the same time, there is a vote also among older people who might have the nostalgia, and certainly there is charm for the Congress workers, except where are the Congress workers? in most districts of UP, district Congress committees are not set up, leaders are not there, and frankly, if Congress does decide to contest, as they are now claiming, all 80 seats, they will struggle to find candidates or at least credible candidates. So that is not going to happen. If you ask me, the best case scenario of the Congress party, the best case scenario would be to repeat the 2009 performance, but that's a very long way off, because today Mr. Modi is a very strong candidate, and it's counterintuitive, but if you look at the polls that are coming out, including the India Today poll, which is quite large, it does look like Yogi Adityanath is not particularly unpopular. He's retained his popularity to some extent. So those 20 seats, 22 seats are going to be very hard to come by. The other possible but good scenario is that so far, because SP and BSP did not see much value in the Congress party's vote, they were keeping the Congress out of their alliance. If this puts pressure on them to accommodate the Congress with a more respectable number of seats, will the Congress agree or not is a question that we'll come to later. But will they now come to Congress and say, all right, we are not giving you just two seats, maybe we'll give you the two seats plus the seven others in which you stood second the last time, which is nine seats, and then you bargain and a little toing and froing and come to a conclusion. Because remember, Congress got 7.5% vote the last time and got two seats. Mayawati's party got nearly 20% vote, got no seats, because that's how it works in first past the post system. So today, for those parties also, it's important to draw every vote towards themselves. So if they think that Priyanka's arrival so rejuvenates the Congress party, starts bringing out the old Congress voters, which is a lot of voters, not majority, but a lot of voters, also energizes some of the youth, makes the Congress spend more resources in UP, and maybe if that 7.5% even goes to 10 or 12% or say about 17%, which was the Congress vote in 2009, then who is it going to affect? And I think both SP and BSP would be wrong if they think that this will affect primarily the BJP, because BJP has committed voters. It will affect BSP and SP. So that is the next sort of possibility for the Congress party, that now if they can show some strength, which they are trying to, and if it is seen as credible, then a larger alliance, they may be accommodated as the third partner in the larger alliance. But a lot of the politics has to yet play out in Uttar Pradesh. The interesting thing is, it is now no longer a simple situation of BJP on the one side, SP-BSP on the other. Congress, it may be the joker in the pack, but still it has now become a factor.